Hello IB students. Now firstly let us start the practical of NumPy. This is the practical part 1, and understand the practical very attentively so that you can do it on your own at your home. Firstly, let's be clear about NumPy. What is NumPy? NumPy is actually a library of Python for scientific computing applications, and it stands for numerical Python. NumPy. Num stands for numerical, py stands for Python. So it is used basically for the scientific computing applications. Now students, the most important thing to be understood is the array, the concept of array in NumPy. Because actually NumPy deals with the array. Now what is an array? Let's understand. An array is a container which can hold a fixed number of items, and these items should be of the same type, right? Just as we have a variable, but that variable holds only one value. What if we need to store multiple values of the same type in the contiguous memory locations? For that we need array. So what is array? Array is a contiguous memory locations which can store multiple values of the same data type. Mind you, it stores the data items of the same type, unlike list, tuple and dictionary. Because list, it might contain the data items of different data types. Like it might contain the integer values also, fractional values also, and like strings also, etc. Right? The mixture of values. But in array, it will have only one type of values. Either all the integer values, or all the fractional values, or all the strings. Okay? And the array is immutable, means you cannot make changes in array, unlike list. So these are some differences between array and list. Now pictorically I'll show you the three types of array which we have to cover. Actually we have to cover only two types of array. You see, this array can be of one dimensional, two dimensional and multi-dimensional. Multi-dimensional means more than two-dimensional, means three-dimensional and so on. So these are the different types of array. Now let us see what are these dimensions. You can see the 1D array. In the 1D array there is only one row. There is only one row having four integer values. Okay, so it is of, I mean its axis is only one, means this is the x-axis. Okay, if you assume the coordinate, in the coordinate, I mean in the graph, there are three coordinates: x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. Okay, so it is along the x-axis only, so it has only one axis. It is called axis 0. Okay, and here we have written shape. Shape, it denotes the number of rows and columns. Okay, since here in 1D array we have only one row, right? Only one row, but there are four columns. So four columns in one row only. That is why shape is 4, right? You can see. Then you have 2D array. Okay, in 2D array there are multiple rows, rows 1 and rows 2. Okay, so there are two row and how many columns? 1, 2, 3 columns. So two rows and three columns. And axis, x-axis and along y-axis. This is y-axis and this is x-axis. So there are two axes in 2D array. Okay, shape is, we denote the shape in terms of rows and columns. Firstly we write row and then columns. So it has got two rows, so 2, 3, first row and second column. In a 1D array, since there are only columns, so columns 4 then comma. Right, so this is the shape of 1D array, this is the shape of 2D array. Similarly, you can see here, this is a 3D array. It has been represented in terms of three axes. Okay, so this is, let us say, this is axis X, and this is Y, and this is Z. You can see like this. Okay, so there are three axes, axis 0, axis 1, and axis 2. There are three axes means length, breadth, and height. Okay, so in this way, the elements of 3D arrays can be represented. Okay, and shape will be 4, 3, 2 means 4 number of rows, 3 number of columns, and 2 the height. Okay, so I mean arrays can be represented in NumPy as this. Now I'll directly go to the NumPy editor where I'll show you how to start doing practicals with the arrays of NumPy. Okay, we'll be doing just 3 or 4 practicals, then in the second part we'll cover the rest of them. Now you can see, okay, you see, in order to do the practicals for NumPy, we need to import firstly the NumPy. Okay, here you can see the NumPy module. Okay, so we have imported import NumPy as NP. NP is the alias name or alternative name for NP. So in the program we will be using NP, although you can use NumPy also. Okay, but since it is a long word, okay, so we have to use the short version of it. NP means its alternative name. Now first let's understand how to create a 1D array. It is very simple. We have to use a function array. Okay, you can see np.array. So array is the function of NumPy, that is why we have written np.array. okay, so np.array, and here you can see we have a list of values, list of 3 values, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we, mind you, we have to always pass the data items in terms of list. Okay, in terms of list only. Okay, it is not that you write directly in the parentheses 1, 2, 3. Okay, without putting this square bracket. Okay, so square bracket will come, right? So we have created an array of these 3 elements 1, 2, 3 and stored it in A. Okay, in this variable A. Now firstly, what we are doing, before printing A, we are printing type of A. You can see type of A, so it will display what is the data type of A. Of course the data type of A is NumPy, right? Then print A dot shape. Okay, now shape is the attribute which tells you about the shape. Okay, means what is the number of rows and columns. Since it has 3 columns, okay, and 0 rows, so it will show you 3. Then we have printed the specific data items. Okay, so specific data items of the array A, okay, it can be represented by using its index. Okay, so A0 means 1, A1 means 2, and A2 means 3. Okay, so we have printed A0, A1, and A2. Now here we are altering the value of A0 means 1. So in place of 1, it will print, it will have 5, it will store 5. Now we are printing A. Okay, so it will be printing actually 5 to 3. Okay, so this is the 1D array. Right, till here 1D array. Now in B we are creating 2D array. How to create 2D array? Very simple, the same function we have to use, array function. So np.array. Now here we are using two list. Okay, list 1, 2, 3, comma second list 4, 5, 6. Okay, so in this way, if you pass multiple list items separated by comma, you can see comma here. right? And now here also I am writing b.shape, so it will display the shape of the array b, which is 2d array. And here we are printing the each and every element, not all the elements but a specific element. Okay, so b00 means b row 0 column 0, b row 0 means first row, and column 1 means second column, b1 means second row, and 0 column means first column. Okay, so it will show you, it will display all the means three elements, okay, according to the indexes. Now you can, if you run this program from here, okay, it will, I have already run it, okay, you can see the first was, you can see here, the first was type of A, okay, so type of A is NumPy, you can see NumPy. Then A.shape, what is the shape of A? There are three columns, 1, 2, 3 columns, so 3, okay. Now next, you can see print A0, A1, A2 means 1, 2, 3, it is printing 1, 2, 3, okay. Now A0 is equal to 5, okay, we have updated the first value, which is 1, okay, with 5. Now print A, now it will be printing 5, 2, 3. Now you can see the output 5, 2, 3, okay, right. Now 2D array B, okay, so in B we have two rows, 1 and 2, and in each row how many columns? 1, 2, 3 columns, okay. Now you can see print B.shape, you can see the shape 2, 3 means number of rows is 2 and number of columns is 3, okay. Then you can see print 0, 0 means first item, first row and first column. What is the first row, first column? 1, okay, so it is printing 1, you can see here, you can see here 1, okay. Then B01 means first row, second column, first row, second column is 2, 2. This is the second row, first column, second row is this, first column is 4, so you can see 4, okay. So in this way you have seen a simple NumPy program where we have created a 1D array in A and 2D array in B, and we have seen how to print all the elements by printing print A and print B, and how to display what type of data it is, so by using type function, type A, and what is the shape, means how many rows and columns are there. So we have used an attribute shape, A.shape, okay. So we have learned type, shape, and how to print individual elements of an array by using its indexes, okay. So in 1D array it is very easy, index starts from 0, okay, 0 till the last, I mean size minus 1, okay. So there are three columns, so 0, 1, 2, this is the index, so 0, 1, 2, okay. So in this way you can also practice at home, okay, if you have Python installed at your system, okay. Now in the next video, I'll be covering some more advanced features, okay. Till then, thank you.